Quand je me tourne vers mes souvenirs, je revois la maison où j'ai grandi. Il me revient des tas de choses. Je vois des roses dans un jardin. Là où vivaient des arbres maintenant, la ville est là et la maison, les fleurs que j'aimais tant n'existent plus. Ils savaient rire, tous mes amis. Ils savaient si bien partager mes jeux. Mais tout doit finir, pourtant dans la vie. Et j'ai dû partir, les larmes aux yeux. Mes amis me demandaient pourquoi pleurer. Et courir le monde vaut mieux que rester. Et tu trouveras toutes tes choses qu'ici on ne voit pas. Toute une ville qui s'endort dans la nuit, dans la lumière. Quand j'ai quitté ce coin de mon enfance, je savais déjà que j'ai laissé mon cœur. Tous mes amis, oui, envient ma chance. Mais moi je pense encore à leur bonheur, à l'insouciance qui le faisait rire. Et il me semble que je m'entends leur dire: je reviendrai un jour en beau matin parmi vos rires. Oui, je prendrai que j'aime. Mais où sont les pierres et où sont les roses, toutes ces choses auxquelles je tenais, belle de mes amis, plus une trace. D'autres gens, d'autres maisons ont volé leur place. Là où vivaient des arbres maintenant, la ville est là.
It touches me when I see a dog waving frantically his tail at the sight of his owner, or a cat clinging to its master, or as in my case, when my favorite rooster will neglect its hens and rather start gently pestering me so as to draw my attention. They evidently love and appreciate their owner very much and are most happy when they are in his or her presence. Well, I know that in heaven I will be much like them. I will be seeking to be as close to God as I possibly can, for that is where perfect peace, perfect happiness and perfect love is to be found. We humans have been created in order to share a close and warm relationship with our Creator. Jesus is the embodiment of perfect love, kindness, holiness, faithfulness, and any other admirable quality I want to have myself. He is the most beautiful and admirable being there is, and my soul thirsts for him. I want to become like him. Jesus and his word, the Bible, is the treasure that I am so pleased to have discovered early in my life. And that is referred in Matthew 13 verse 44, where it is written, "A man unexpectedly discovered a treasure and proceeded to sell everything he had in the world in order to buy that land where the treasure was hidden and make it his own." Jesus is my treasure, and so is his written word that I value more than anything, and I am willing to forsake everything in this life so as to be made as he instructs me, pleasing and acceptable to him, knowing that the more I will become like him, the more happy I will be in eternity. I am determined to cooperate with his spirit and bear whatever unpleasant training he may have to put me through in this life, whether sorrow, pain, disappointment, tragedy, or downright misery, so as to become more like him and closer to him. I do not want to become like some of the pets I had that I loved and took them in my home, only to find them tearing the curtains and destroying the furniture, eating my shoes, snatching food from the table, and pooing everywhere. In the end, I had to chase them out of my house. This must not happen to me. While here on earth, I must take every effort to learn to be acceptable and pleasing to my God. No! They're falling off. The reason why I am still here on earth and why I was not taken to heaven when I became a follower of Jesus is that I must first be made clean. I must be purified from all of my impurities. I must be corrected in my wrongs. I must be trained and tested under God's hard and often unpleasant treatment so as to become more like Jesus, my role model, an approved companion of his that he will love to spend time with in eternity. In other words, I am willing to accept the unpleasant and distressing events that I already bear in my life, the schooling and discipline that is necessary for me to become the best I can ever be for Jesus, who is my God, my Savior, my treasure. Does your soul thirst and long to become the best you could ever be, even if you may have to go through a lot of suffering and discipline in this world for it? Are you willing to give up every pleasure you may have in order to get hold of this treasure that you will enjoy fully in God's heavenly kingdom? Jesus said that among those who will be with him after their resurrection, there will be many who will be guests, but few that will be among the chosen ones, the elite. That is written in Matthew 20, verse 16. I strive to become among the elite. Elite. How do we say it? I don't know. What about you? Bye.